down at the boatyard at Barton. And I've never been in here, but for myself, for painting, it looks fascinating. Okay. Beautiful boats that they're renovating.
Formula One, they're measured with aluminium templates around the outside with tolerances, and then they've got a date inscribed. There's a thing called St. George, and it's the St. George's class. It's really interesting. That's just the old owner of the yard here.
The cobble there?
Yeah. We just that was built in 1908, I think, or 1906.
On a different boat, actually sailed...
On this boat, sailed across the Atlantic.
Sailed on this boat across the Atlantic at the age of 19, which is incredible. It was actually built in 1961.
By Priors of Burnmon Crouch.
Right. Here we have a traditional Yorkshire sailing cobble. I've been meaning to do a painting, do some work down at the boatyard in Barton for quite a while now, and I went down to have a look around a few years back and did some exterior filming and was looking at doing the history of the place, but it seemed to slide aside. Patrick was working there a while and enjoyed some time there. So anyway, I went down the other day and got some nice photographs, and I thought, well, I've got a big one, quite a challenge. And do it with mixed medium here, well, do it with mixed methods, possibly using the sponge roller and so on, and just see where we go with it. First thing is, it's a challenge in the drawing itself. It's a big piece of work, and the drawing is quite complicated, so that's the first thing to map out and just see where we go from there. Really, I'm slightly open-ended on it. I've got some ideas as to where it can go, but tonally it should be very interesting, and it's certainly going to be a challenge. Let's see where we go with this one then. Thank you. got the basics of the drawing done, now I've got to decide where I want these figures, or the figure, because I've got two photographs, I'll just show you them, and in one the figure is on the left hand side, right up close here, and in the other it's towards the middle, and I have to decide which one I think is going to be better for this particular painting. It's quite hard to tell because the scale is quite large, and if I put a figure here, it's going to give good scale to the size of the boats. Equally, if I put a figure here, it could lead into the boats. So that's my next decision as to what to do. Well, in the end, I decided to put the figure here, not over here. I'd like this light blue area showing through here. And hopefully the figure will just lead the eye in and through. See how it goes. So I want to try and build up the tones and colours in the background. Ready to go down there and paint in situ, and also want to get that figure fairly well established so that I can work it in with the actual scene down there. Thank you. Well, I think I've probably done enough on the base coats now to get the atmosphere and the textures and the different blocks of tones and hues. Now I'll wait until maybe next Wednesday before I refresh my paints and actually go down and hopefully really pull out some of these colours with the slabs again with a square brush. So that's that for the moment. Thank you. Well, time to carry on with this one. Now, I'm not quite happy with this here yet. I thought putting the light across the face would work, but maybe it's stands out a bit too much yet. I need to get that clarified. And it's this area that I want to work around yet and pull certain things out, which will aid me when I actually go down there. And then all of this around here, I hope to do when I'm actually down there. Obviously, I've only spent one time there. I hope to spend just one session down there to really find more colour and get the ambience of the actual place. And then I'll work back here again, work between the two. Thank you. Well, I'm a little bit afraid of this. I wanted to take this painting down in the next few days to work on site. Didn't want to take it too far. Of course, just carrying on working, it's almost come to completion now. I don't know whether to go down there or not, because actually it is finished. I could put a bit more in. Perhaps if I take it down and take a look, it might give me some ideas. Otherwise, it's done. Anyway, that's as far as we've got with that. So I think I've come to the conclusion that I don't really need to go down to the boatyard to play with it. But I just want to add a few more lighter tints here and there. A pure white now, so I've finished. I can afford to use the lighter colours a little bit more heavily just to bring out these light tones and give a lot more luminosity to the scene. So I'll just finish off with these pure whites. Really try and get the effect of this light flooding down and through. You see, if I use black or I use white, then it's going to go against the darker or the lighter colours and bring them out. So if I'm using pure white now at the very end, I can't go lighter than white, I can actually just bring out these paler colours and give them more luminosity. The other colours glow through slightly. You can see how this white now brings out the other lighter colours around and gives it far more dimension and light. There we are, I think we'll call that completed.